All right. Wow. Not only is this our largest group ever, but it's our first time ever bringing families together to steam in the park. So this is your official welcome to Steam in the Park, family style in Acadia National Park. Yes. We are gonna have an amazing adventure this week, I promise you. It's gonna take us a little bit of time to get our mojo going to make sure we can keep an eye out on everyone. But I promise you this week is gonna be filled with lots of fun activities. It's gonna be filled with you getting to know yourself, your families, and other families and making connections. Now, once you get a number, you're responsible for the people in that number. So if I say group number one, you gotta make sure everybody you came with is in that group, okay? Normally, Steve and I work with about 30 to 40 educators a week, so we don't count above that. So all these extras, you'll have to make sure you hold on to them also. Schaefer, 1, Danius, 2, Shalini, 3, Sanchez, 4, Sellers, 5, Skiles, 6, Kearns, 7, Whittington, 8, Downs, 9, Johnson, 10, Corvaline, 11, Switzer, 12, Jet, 13, Kane, 14, Phillips, 15, Emmons, 16, Pritz, 17, and France, 18.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Welcome to Acadia.
Oh yes, it's beautiful.
We love it already.
You've been having a good time, or
yes.
Some of you have.
Yeah. I'm not a sheep.
We hope that you have a great whole week here.
Yes.
That's right. We will. I'm Kate Petrie. I'm the education coordinator for Acadia. What I'm going to show you tonight is just a little bit of the intro to our residential education program, which hangs on a theme of communicating through mapping and graphing. And I don't know about you, but I think that's cool.
Me too.
I love
it.
Yeah.
Dexter.
This is all part of Maine. It's not the whole state. But take just a moment to walk around and explore it.
Hey guys.
Maine has a lot of towns in it that are named after other countries.
That's because where Wilbur Tippert was.
Yeah. And we went through this town. Right?
Oh, this is the line. This is the border.
The things that are so neat about maps is that a map like this fits in one room. If we were to write out in full sentences everything that this map was telling us, it would fill a book as thick as a dictionary.
A big dictionary.
That. Because there's so much information that can be conveyed in pictures if you know the translation.
And you might think, oh my gosh, I'm not an artist, I'm not somebody that can draw, but it's more than that. It's taking in the nature around you.
The point is waking up, paying attention, noticing, and exploring. The point is remembering again and again that the world we inhabit is infinitely rich, complex, fascinating, and beautiful.
So let's get a little messy here as we make some of our firefly lights. So we're going to ask that each family come up and use materials found on the table.
Load it up.
I'm scared to burn it.
Thanks for it.
They're all gone.
I think being a Boy Scout is a lot.
That's all we have for tonight. Thank you so, so much. Our goal was to sugar your kids up and then send them back into your apartment. But, all right, wow. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
But welcome, everyone, to Steam in the Park Day 2. All right, will you also take a minute to introduce yourself to the people at your table?
And high school AP.
Awesome. It's going to be interesting.
Your name is?
Are you going to give him your real name or your nickname?
She was the
okay. And we all love Holiday World.
Kids and parents and brothers and sisters and moms and dads and grandparents, our goal this week is to embrace each other. Okay? We're going to think of ways that we can support each other as a family. And we're going to model after the redwood tree. So if you know anything about the redwood trees, their roots are not deep, but they are wide. So when the tree grows, the roots don't have a lot of space to go down, but they spread out. And if Melanie is a redwood tree and her roots start to spread out, and then I'm beside her, my root will actually grab hold of hers, and we support each other and hold each other up. And that's what we want to do this week. We hope that when we leave here on the last day, that there may be a few tears, that you found a buddy or a new family you can connect with. We're from all over the place, so 61 of us from different backgrounds, but we hope to leave as a family. In the middle of your table, there are some Scrabble tiles. Can you each, one at a time, take one, flip it over, and see if you can come up with a word of how you're feeling this morning? All right, as a whole team there.
Last night, so where's your family? Well, I wasn't sure if I should claim them last night. I heard they were making a little bit of a ruckus.
Whittington, I am a K through 5 teaching assistant. I have
We're also going to be introducing to you this new book called Mimic Makers.
So it's from fins to fans. It says the bumpy blades on this turbine helps make clean energy. As wind blows on the blades, the turbine spins and turns the wind's energy into electricity.
This one's my favorite. This sticky stuff is based on a prototype that is so strong that a piece the size of your hand can stick a motorcycle to the wall.
But can we give a wonderful Acadia Family Steam in the Park welcome to Jennifer.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me. My book is called Footprints Across the Planet. This is me. I'm the author of about 50 books for kids, mostly about STEM and STEAM. What we're going to do, we are going to draw an outline of our shoes, and in that outline, you are going to draw things you like to do, and this will show your impact on the planet. So as you can see, I'm not the illustrator.
This is called Level Up. A Level Up challenge is where you decide what you're going to do to earn points. The goal is to earn 20 points today. We're looking for things that are dead, down, and on the ground if you pick anything up and use it in your journal. Nice.
Who here calls it a grilled cheese? And then I think I heard somebody call it a cheese toastie.
You better believe it.
Okay, so we're going to get started on our nature journaling activity. So we had a little introduction to the nature journaling yesterday evening. So I have loved the nature journaling activities that I implemented. I implemented them only with first grade last year. just to kind of get my feet wet, and I had no idea what I was doing. But it went really, really well. And the things that I love about it, and I think I heard it it's about a way to understand something and it helps you notice more. I think one of the things that I love the most that I noticed with my first graders was their sense to slow down. Do everything that I do.
Do everything that I do.
And everything that I say.
And everything that I say.
Going on a crab hunt.
Going on a crab hunt.
Gonna catch a big one.
Gonna catch a big one.
I'm not scared.
I'm not scared.
Cause I got my pole and my net by my side.
Cause I got my pole and my net by my side.
It's a lovely day.
It's a lovely day.
Tall trees.
Tall trees.
Green grass.
Green grass.
And look at all the water.
And look at all the water.
That's it. So I'm gonna say, for the first time during this whole summer, everyone please meet Bonnie Shalene. Wow. Wow.
Is that me?
And I'm gonna lift it up to show you. So I just rocked it from side to side. Then I'm gonna peek. And you just go real gentle. Hope you didn't have it too wet. So I just went all the way around it. And it was a little hard to pull it off, because I probably should have dried it a little bit more. So
my name is Ranger Missy, and I will be leading one of our programs, if you so choose to go on it. We have here Ranger Matt, who will be leading another program that'll be staying here. But you have a fun activity. Do you want to explain what it is?
Ranger? Sure. So we'll be over in this area, and we're going to play a game based on the water cycle, where you are pretending to be a drop of water. So we'll be kind of central in the centralized area over there.
And then for mine, we're going to be taking just a short hike around the campus, and we're going to talk about the crepuscular animals, these animals that come out at twilight. So hopefully, maybe you'll hear about some of the animals and maybe later on spot them. So we're going to give you guys the choice.
So tonight, we're going to talk about two incredible things, families and nature. Families are like a team of superheroes, and spending time together in nature is like their secret power that brings them even closer.
I'm Roxy. This is Bo. He also goes by Django now. And this is Eli.
Okay, I'm Jen Shillany.
I'm Shania Tate.
Bonnie Shillany.
Okay, we're from Illinois. We're from near Chicago. She's from Southern Illinois.
Right, my name is Daniel, and this is my wife, Melanie. We are from Maryland.
I'm John Paul. This is my son, Truth, my wife, Beth, my daughter, Rowan.
Hey, I'm Brittany, and this is my sister, Charlie, and we're from Evanston, Illinois.
Hi, I'm Trisha. This is my husband, Eric, and our daughter, Kaylee. Our son isn't with us. He's in college studying abroad this summer, so sad that he's not here, but his name is also Eric. We're also from a suburb of Chicago, Illinois.
All right, I'm Tayshia, my husband Jacob, Chloe, and Zane, and we're from Covington, Indiana.
The Downs family.
I'm Asa. This is Ridgely.
Andrea. We're from Central Illinois.
My name's Anna Johnson. This is
Jared.
Jake.
And Jay. And we live in Sunnyside, Georgia.
Oh, I like the state.
I know, right?
Hello, everyone. We're the Corvallines. I'm Helen.
I'm Greg.
I'm Gabe.
I'm Grace.
And we come from right outside of Princeton, New Jersey.
All right. We're the Schweitzers. I'm Sarah.
Oh, I'm Mark.
Trevor. Matthew. We're from California, Southern California.
Okay. We're the Jet family plus Granddaddy, who is also Jim Jordan. This is Tamla. I'm Taryn. This is James. And this is Matthew. And then our cousin Christian is in the car right now. But we're from West Columbia, South Carolina, and
rowdy now. Dawn's here.
We are the Canes. I'm Dawn, and this is my husband, Sean. And we have three grown adult children who are glad for us to be here. They're triplets who are 26-ish. I don't remember at this point.
That's cute. I'm Katie. That's Remy.
And he's off.
Hi, Kai.
Can anyone say who you are?
I'm Kai.
This is Aiden.
I'm Aline.
Oh, no.
Oops, can you guys get it? Okay, hey. This is a disaster.
I'll introduce us first.
Alright, I'm Jenny, and this is Gabriel James. He likes to go by James. We're from Durham, North Carolina.
Hello, we are Team 17. If you are wondering, yes, we are the Fire Alarm family. So I am Marissa, the oldest. She's Cassidy.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Ryan.
Yeah. Alright, so I'm Stephanie. This is Lindsay, Cooper, Bridget. We're from Southern Indiana, like as far south as you can go before Kentucky.
So we're going to do one more thing, and we're going to take a family picture because this is just too beautiful not to take one, like from both ways. We'll try to do that. Just hold on to people. But so I'm now turning it over to them. They are totally in charge. So
I say, grab the rope.
Come on, James.
Don't forget to yell, grab the rope. Oh! So here's what we're gonna do. We are gonna make a chicken wing circle. I'm gonna squeeze it right here. Three volunteers. Maybe someone who didn't get to do the throw bag. Okay, so we know this takes, how long does this process take for the Earth to get all the way around the sun?
365
and one quarter. That's why we have leap year. Okay, and that takes about 27 days. Okay, and we're not showing the difference. There's actually a tilt right here. Okay, crabs, which they know that the seagulls are flying over, they'll hide under rocks. That's a behavioral adaptation.
Crayfish! And crayfish!
Oh. I'll give you the tools and stuff, explain what to do, and then we'll hit the tide.
Okay, so take your time with it all of what you should be thinking about in terms of the critters and being down there. They don't want us to probably be in
there. I think you got the big one.
I mean, I got this, and I just can't.
Leave no trace as much as possible. So into the water, but only ankle deep, please. And we're not gonna go, if you guys look to your right, you'll start to see some mud flats out there. And earlier this season, those mud flats held on to some shoes. So we don't. Welcome everyone to day three! Woo! So we've already had a great morning out in the tide pools. Someone tell me their most fun experience out of the tide pools. Be really loud. Go, go.
I watched Mr. Cringe get pinched by my crush.
Nice. You loved other people's. Yay! We're sharing the pain. Love it. What else?
Our group found something that the rangers didn't exactly know what it was, so yeah. They brought it back to figure it out.
Yeah, so they're going to actually send it into iNaturalist and see if any of the scientists on there can identify it. And they'll get back to us. Very good. All the way in the back.
That's email.
Finding a world record kelp.
Do you want me to translate?
Yes.
Finding a world record kelp.
It was. Smaller than his head. Wow. And it was all in one piece. The little crab people found a crab mother to be, so they took that one and they're going to see it through. And then they also found a special type of snail that hadn't been found for a while, so they were going to take that back. This was their words. The good things, meeting new people, new experiences. They love the free time and the breaks. The shared experience with their family. These things are hard. Game time! say things, we remember things. So we're going to do another journaling activity today that has to do with listening and hearing. So we're going to be doing something called Soundscape.
All right. I'm glad to hear your feedback on journaling because it takes a little bit of practice to really get to where you feel comfortable with it. Today we're going to be working on listening. What I want you to know is that there is not one way to journal. You can do any way you like. You want to find, first of all, find a place and sit and listen, which can be hard. And not just listen for a minute, but like a whole real minute, which can be hard. Just close your eyes, hear what you hear, and then open your eyes and begin journaling, begin writing or drawing. Welcome back. So I do want to hear some reflections, but before we do that, I want to give you just a minute to find somebody, not in your family, maybe even a different table, and share with them what you did. And just pause for a minute, find somebody to share your journal entry with. I'll give you a few minutes to do that, and then we'll come back for a reflection.
My name is Ranger Missy, and I'll be leading us through our touch tape program. You're going to see a couple of the things kind of repeat themselves from our earlier experience, just because not everybody gets to go out and tide pool, but some of these facts might be similar to what you've already heard too. If you guys have questions along the way, feel free to just raise your hand, but I might say, hey, hold on to them until the very end. Does that sound okay? Yes. Fabulous. Okay, so we're gonna get started with one of my favorite animals.
So tonight is all about the invasive green crabs. You guys got to meet some of them today. And no matter how cute you think they are very invasive. Tomorrow, and we'll give you the schedule in just a minute, each family that presents will get the coveted Protector of the Tide Pools plaque. I need a little ooh-in.
Ooh.
And a family copy of 100 Ways to Help Save the Earth.
Oh.
Nice. I know you're pretty impressed with us.
Yeah.
You should be. This is our schedule tomorrow. I want to get
Just
like the
pavement,
and then all of a sudden,
I'm
just
saying,
thing.
Oh,
I've never had a York one before.
Oh, you're burning, kid. You're burning.
Yeah, kid. I'm not a kid.
Yo, you're all right.
My rock. It's like charred. Oh, watch that marshmallow. Oh, wait, no.
Again this morning, I was just saying that you've experienced all of the weather that Maine has to offer. Yesterday was bright and sunny and hot. Right now, so far, we've got a fair amount of fog, which is quite common for us, but we think that it's going to lift and burn off, and we'll have another nice sunny time at the tide pools. So we are going to, depending on your group, we're going to be spending quite a bit of time at that same location as we did yesterday, called Little Moose Island. It's an island at high tide, but of course going at low tides when we want to do our tide pooling, so we can get across. One, two, three, collect!
Start. Yay! Wait, we don't have to. Any data, just crabs. Grab crabs, throw them in the bucket.
Paper and a pencil, three things. Awesome. Thank you for your attention. So everybody has a sheet of paper with a title that says Ranger Title Crab Survey. Or study. Thank you. So we are, of course, looking what type of crab live in our intertidal zone across the state. And Little Moose Island is just one of many sites. So why do you think they're looking at crabs? Maybe some of my crayfish people. What was some of the issues we talked about a little bit yesterday with some of the crabs we were finding? Yeah. They're invasive. So they're really looking at native versus non-native versus invasive. So those are three different terms. What does native mean? Can someone tell me? Right here.
It's like adapted to the area, and it's like normally in the area.
It's normally in the area, it's adapted to the area. That's gonna be our rock crab and our Jonah crab. We'll talk about identifying those in a second. What's a non-native species? Not crabs necessarily, but what does non-native mean? Yeah.
So the invasive species are the ones that came from somewhere else and are now leaving the population of other crabs.
Right. So is a non-native species necessarily invasive?
No.
Right. So I'm not native to the coast of Maine, but I live here now and I think I'm doing okay.
Have a good day. So from what I understand, we were able to upload data for about 80 plus different crabs found in the park. So that's a really good number for you guys. So thank you so much for doing that. You were great community scientists and we appreciate you.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. As a junior ranger, I will do my best.
Today is our first ever engineering design challenge for Acadia Steeman, the park family edition. You're getting so much better on roos. I love that. Sounds good. All right, so we're going to start. I'm just going to call out. Decided was that obviously we needed something to hold the crabs.
Need a hotel under the sea, come on down to Pinching, beat the tide, come to Pinching, go sweet. Woo!
This is very simple design. You know, the green crabs, they're not very strong swimmers, so they just crawl and they go up the...
So we're going with the concept. How many of you know, remember Hungry Hippos?
Yes!
So, you don't...
Okay, so this is Charlie and Britt's green crab hotel.
Crab-a-dia. Crab the day.
Mid fish and chips because they're European.
So,
so crab did. He follows it. He'll touch the thing that we're holding.
We open up it, and then that's the muscle, and then we scoop it up.
So our trap works by using an inclined plane to get the crabs to walk up, and we keep the bait at the top.
The crab will go up this, and we'll be able to fit through there, and then up.
Applications for making this crab, why do we have to have some kind of mechanical device? So this is the incline.
In an hour, chop it down if you want, right? So we spent a lot of our time researching. We were trying to find out what set the rock crab and the Jonah crab.
We can take the door and put it here, and then
I like to introduce a machine without a name, but I myself like to call it Trap the Crab. So
that's our buoy. We got real creative there. So this was the entrance, which has,
and the B is for bow, and the E is for Eli, right?
Right? No one lets you come and do that.
Write down the team number.
Well, Dad.
One,
two, three. Dad, we're going to play
basketball.
You got to go.
I'm already going.
No, you just keep going.
Yeah.
Okay. You doing a magic show over here? Well, not time. Alright, let's try it again.
I'm not. This is what happens to me. Pops, there's two bags. One up at a time.
Yeah.
One up at a time.
Oh! Okay,
look at it. Run this slow.
Yep, get tired. It's not happy. Ready? Yeah.
Oh, oh, no. No, that's not right.
I tossed it.
Okay, ready?
Come on, nice. We need nothing.
Oh! No. I said no. I stayed right there.
But you're only really like. So you're getting four cards. You're keeping.
Oh! She got two.
Yeah! So
Doesn't matter which
number
corner.
Two, no. Oh, I can do this one through anybody. You pass it back to her.
Right now, you
gave her a potato.
More than four somehow.
Let's go.
Don't get any ideas.
We are firefly friends forever entwined. In this journey, memories we divide. Together we shared laughter and tears, celebrating the beauty of the passing years.
So those are what we call firefly friendships. And no, we're not a cult. But we are a group of passionate people with the same mission to try to get people to love each other and be good humans in this world.
It's a little cheesy, but it's me, and I love it, and you're going to like it too, because I invited you here. Okay, just kidding. But yes.
It's like killing roaches. It's like, I can't do it.
Okay.
Hold on. So just come from behind and like grab them from the bottom. Oh, two of them.
Ah!
Take your pick.
Okay, but I can't get to behind him. So yeah,
you can just grab him. He doesn't have a primary pincher. Just grab him. Oh. You got it.
I can't do this. Okay, hold on. I'm going to get this one.
All right, now grab that one. You can do it.
I'm going to get him.
You're going to do it.
There's some crabs over here.
Ah, yeah. Yay!
All right. Here we go.
Just.
And.
Oh,
Come on now.
Oh, it is a video.
There you go.
Come on, get those wheelbarrows up.
There you go. Get them wheelbarrows up.
Hands. All right, I'm good.
Right. That was a broken wheelbarrow. Come on. That was a pitiful wheelbarrow.
Put your hands on the ground.
I don't.
Your little trick.
Okay. Yeah. Show us how it's done.
Ready?
I can't do it. Yeah, see, I can't get up.
Go. Walk. Because I can't stand still.
Go. Anything that's not, they need to break it down flat.
Break it down. Okay. Sorry, things aren't moving really good. Pizza with ice cream cupcakes in the pizza. Yes. All right.